Hey, what's going on? So I have been a Godox 8600 Pro user for quite some time. And well, I guess there was a period where I didn't use it for a little bit. And the batteries, which they cost about $180 US dollars, and they're very expensive, right? So it died. It does nothing. If I charge it, nothing happens. If I push the button to find out how charged it is, I get nothing. And apparently, this is an issue with these batteries. Now, I was at the point where I was about to say screw it and switch light brands. I was going to go from Godox to Westcott or Godox to something else, Gikoto, I don't know. I was going to do a major change, and I didn't want to have to spend that kind of money right now. I wanted to just stick with the Godox lights because they served me well otherwise. But this was getting very annoying. And I didn't want to have to replace two of these batteries because at that point, I could literally buy a new light. So I did a little bit of research and turns out this is a known issue where if you stop using the battery for a little bit of time, it just depletes and it is dead in the water. And there is a way to solve this problem, which I want to show you right now. I'm going to show you my top-down desk view from my iPhone, and don't mind the clutter, don't mind the mess. I just wanted to show you how this is to get solved. So the first steps are to take off these screws in order to open up the actual product. There are six screws that have to come off in order to do this. There's these four on the outside, and then there's these two on the inside, and that allows me to take the cover off and get to where I need to get on the inside. Now, I would never recommend for anybody to do this because you could shock yourself. It's a little dangerous if you don't know what you're doing, but I will say that the battery is completely depleted, so that also means any capacitors inside, they are also depleted because they've had nothing to charge them in quite some time. So, with that said, I'm pretty safe to be doing what I'm doing right now, but if you're unsure, then don't do it yourself. Okay, so I just unscrewed everything. I'm taking the cover off. Put that aside. The only other thing you have to do is identify those two holes. Then you need to get yourself a paperclip or something like that, and you're going to bend it into a U-shape, and you're gonna stick, there's apparently a reset in here that if these two are connected, it recycles the entire thing. You're going to stick each end into one of these holes and push it enough that it definitely goes through. Don't let it pop out. So I got one in and there's the other end. Let it stay there for about 5 to 10 seconds. And then you're gonna just remove it, put the cover back on and plug the battery in. That is all you have to do. This little bit, this little change, this sort of completing the circuit type of effect is all that has to be done to reset this battery. So now I'm gonna take that out. I'm gonna put the cover back on. And by the way, I know this is working because I have my other one currently charging behind me on my desk behind me, and it is charging. So this worked. I don't understand how. I don't understand why they designed it this way either, but it is working, and I just saved myself from having to replace two $180 batteries. A little crazy that they're that expensive, but it is what it is. Now, when you plug this in, it is not going to show anything in the status bar right away. You have to let it charge for a little bit before you see any indication of status. And I'll show you what I mean in a second. Okay, so right now, if I was to click on it, still no status. But this is my other one that I have been charging. And if I click it, you actually see the red dot, meaning it's very, very, very low. But if I leave it charging, it is going to charge. Now, if you are seeing this video right now on YouTube, then that means that this worked perfectly and I'm showing you a hack, so to speak, a workaround, I don't even know what to call it, to bring a dead Godox 8600 battery back to life. If you are not seeing this video, then that means that this did not work and they're just dead in the water anyway. So there we go. Thanks for watching.